crime fighters and pervert suits coming out the woodwork.
Pervert suits?
I asked, caught by his breathing.
Yeah, it's like there's some kind of law or something. Ordinary bloke requires the power to turn his head into a teapot. He has to start punching around in low-grade fishnets. I stopped him from the rocky ore, innit? You know what? That sort of thing turns my stomach. There ought to be a law against this. What? Turning his head into a teapot? No, the pervert suits.
And if I had my choice of superpowers, I would cheerfully sell my soul for the ability to turn my driver's head into a cafetiere. I'm so tense by the time we arrive that I forget to ask for a receipt when I pay. But swearing won't help, and I don't feel like running after the taxi. So I make my way stiffly to the front desk, where a splendidly uniformed doorman waits behind a desk carved from the timbers of an 18th century man-o-war. I present my warrant card.
Dr. O'Brien.
I'm here for a meeting in room 4102. It sounds so much better than disciplinary hearing. If you care to sign here, Mom. Now stare into the camera just for a second. It's one of the ubiquitous eyeball on a stock webcam. Disquietingly like something I once met in a hotel hallway in Amsterdam. I tried to will the lens to crack. But I'm not quite ugly enough. Now I'm just going to print you out a badge. Remember to wear it at all times and return it when you leave. You'll have to leave those bags here. You can check them into the cloakroom, but I'm afraid we'll have to scan them. You can take the suitcase, but the violin has to stay with me. I put it on the desk. You're welcome to inspect it right here, but I can't let it out of my possession. Rather valuable. I tense up, anticipating the fight.
Really?
He smiles over gilt-framed half-moon glasses. Well, if you insist, I can hand-search it. Bless the Corps of Commissioners. They're ex-military enough to know when to bend the rules. We deposit my suitcase. I show him Lecter, and let him hand-check the sides and back of the case. Then I take my badge, and go in search of the borrowed conference room. It's funny how the mere anticipation of a verbal confrontation can be worse than life and death combat. My stomach is hollow, and chest a little fluttery. The floors in this building are paved in Italian marble, uncarpeted, utterly lethal if you slip, and liable to cause permanent hearing damage if you walk on them for too long in heels. It's enough to make me long for the beige institutional carpet of the new annex. And then I'm standing in front of a pair of imposing black double doors, framed by Corinthian columns, surmounted by an arch with painted putti, blowing on the sails of ships of the line. I take a deep breath and knock. Twice. Vikram opens the door. He looks nearly as nervous as I feel. Oh, good. Get it, he says.
Don't worry.
This is the house. I asked him. Yes. He's been running into the woods, but still. I'm sure of that. Come on. And we have coffee and patience. I follow.
Thank you.
information covering the spread of abilities. Left slap. We bring the on-screen hand here that shows a graphic bell curve of Gaussian distribution, with the left side cut off around the 80th percentile. Really lucky. Really minor anomalies don't show up at all. I mean, we've got no way of identifying a 4-year-old who's properly all these hands when she calls it, have we? Or a taller man who can cull fishes, butted over quota and landed them illegally on the black market in Italy. Now, if you do involve in the ability to control animals, it's a bit more obvious, especially if they attract attention by making the passing police force tag dance for their pets. And at the other end of the bell curve, they stick out like a sore thumb. There was that business in London so last week with Crazy Public. Negative parts. Fan scenes of war. mountain to get to see it. Not the force of the mountain, but the concrete seat 1.5 meters above the suspended tiles. And is 145 centimeters tall, 4 feet and 9 feet of an old one, and weighs 50 kilos. The way outweighs her, 41. Then there's Geraldine Fawcett, 82 of Oakshott, who is taken to wearing the Schnepp Rose and the Mary Widow, and quite late night noise music is by. But those aren't for another couple of increasingly surreal, not to say implausible minutes, before the ASA appears as they want to get. Yes. As you have already noted, you have limited time. Can I suggest we proceed to the psychological media profile problem next? Is that ordinary people who know nothing about our business interpret their new abilities in terms of their pre-existing cognitive biases. Essentially, it would have been framed in terms of miracles and angels and devils. Witchcraft, in other words. But this is the 21st century in vision, where the most rapidly growing religious demographic is none of the above. And for the past few decades, if in a media environment where a particular fictional genre has been growing in popularity, I refer, of course, to the American Civil War movie. What about comics? Asks the girl with the flyaway wheel. He seems confused. Surely Marvel and DC are somewhat to blame. I remember when they first arrived on these shores in the 1960s. Yes, comics too, I suppose. But movies reach a bigger audience. He looks as if he's been battered all over his ground until it's turned into mud. Superman, Iron Man, Batman, Flowery Rear, blinks invisibly. You name it. Rich, powerful, white albinos who dress up in pink suits and beat up ethnically diverse lower class criminals. Reprehensible lawless vigilantes. It would be so much easier if we had huge or grown gods and demigods to deal with instead. ACPO are spitting blood. ACPO is the Association of Chief Police Officers. They're not a trade union for sycophants. It handles a lot of outsourced high-level police and policy work on behalf of the Home Office. The Home Office takes vigilantes in life as much as does outfits, almost as much as the Ring Lawbreakers. You see, superheroes are following the rules of everything. They take procedural shortcuts, so criminals mess up crime scenes and generally make it almost impossible to control. They've brought the meeting forward an hour. Dr. O'Brien, Agent Candid. He nods at me. As you can see, our organization has been dragged into dangerously close proximity to the public sphere by the incorrigible problem. In particular, Mahogany Row are desperately keen to stay out of the limelight. So, in order to avoid compromising our core mission, we need to generate a semi-classified proxy to deal with the superhero problem. Dominique, I can't. This use of my first name is unusual enough to put my adrenal glands on fight or feel it. Thank you. wanted and expected was to receive my entirely justified bulletin behind closed doors, then to go home and give them a new garden, and then a session with a beautiful therapist, or maybe a talk to the marriage guidance counselor. Not to mention a sweet word of Emma about being in the search for a suitable candidate to take over a certain family across the town. It's a long shot. Thank you.